Hi guys, Greg here and welcome back to SiteEng. Today I'm very excited as this is the first video about women in construction and my guest here today is Eddie.
Hi,
how are you, Eddie?
I'm good, very well, excited to be here.
Yeah, thank you very much for coming here. Guys, Eddie is currently working as a project manager assistant, but we both worked together on the job, on the Battersea Power Station job, where she was my assistant. She was an engineer assistant by then, and I was doing site engineering, mostly doing setting out. Thank you very much again for coming here, for being with us today. And my first question is going to be, how you actually started in construction? How you actually started your career in the industry?
I started my first job around 4 to 5 years ago, and I had enough of my previous job. It was in a completely different sector, and I wanted to change something, and I got the opportunity to apply for a position of document controller without the experience, which in my case was really good because I had no experience at that time, and also I have no university like in the construction sector, so I was like brand new. And I applied for this position, I got this job, and this is how I started to work in construction. But very quick, I changed to junior engineer position, and this is actually a funny story I like to tell.
Okay, that's great.
The first day I started, the contract manager came in on site, and he actually said he's got a different plan for me, and he more see me on site working as a junior engineer, and he said that I might learn more, and also after the time I can do setting out by myself and get more money and what I'm thinking about that. I really wanted to get that job. I really wanted to start working in construction, so I said, why not, let's try. And this is how I become a junior engineer and started to do the setting out. So this is how it all started in my case.
Okay, yeah, great to hear that. That's actually, yeah, that's what happens sometimes on site. So they try to push you into something else. But I think this is great actually that Eddie took the opportunity, and as she said, she worked actually on site. And remember guys, working on site is always the best, especially when you're starting. That's the big eye opener for you. So I think that contract manager did a big favor to Eddie actually before she jumped
right.
into office. Yeah, so you can hear now. I always advise people to go to site if they can, obviously. My another question would be, what you actually do like and what you don't like about construction, about working, about working on site, really?
So the best thing about being on site, working in construction for me, is how you can see the progress of the job. So in a matter of weeks, there are a lot of changes. And it's very exciting when you know that you are a part of it. When you go outside, you see how the building is going up. That part I like the most, that I can see all the time what I am doing and how the job is going. And this is something I really like. And something I don't like is the weather conditions. This is the reason why actually I changed my job. So I was a junior engineer and I meant to do setting out. But for me, weather conditions were too difficult, and on the summertime was fine, but when the winter comes, it was very, very hard when it was raining, when it was cold, and being 10 hours a day, sometimes even more outside, that was too much for me. So then I decided to go back to my previous plan and being a document controller, because like being outside so many hours, 5-6 days a week, it was just too much. So that is the biggest minus working outside.
Okay, yeah. I think it also when we just talked before about working on site, this is why I also recommend you to work on site, guys. I know lots of people are aiming for the project manager position. It's always the best when you're going to put your hands, you're going to work with people. You see, like Eddie said, the weather conditions were too harsh for her, and she actually moved back to the office again, like originally she wanted to do. And as she said, construction is really satisfying job, guys. It's changing on the daily basis. You can see the progress, you know, week by week, you see the floors by floor. So this is very satisfying. And I think that's one of the most important thing in construction. So you can see actually like you took a part in this project and the project's going on, and you put like a small brick to all that big wall. And my another question would be actually, as steel construction is a male-dominated world, and I want you to tell us actually, how do you feel about it and how the work in construction on site is looking from a woman's perspective, from your perspective?
So in my case, I almost never had any bad experience. I never felt any difference that I am a woman on site. Everything was same. Everyone was always very nice and helpful. And to be honest, sometimes I could even took the advantage that I am a woman, especially when some heavy stuff have to be moved around in office. I could always ask guys if they can help me. They never say no. And I believe if I was a guy, they might say no. So sometimes it is a plus to being a woman and the only one on site. There is also maybe 1-2% situations when someone is not as it should be, might be rude and not treating you as he should because you are a woman. But I never had this kind of situation with the management team, with the project managers, engineers, more likely with the workforce. And in this case, you always have to speak with the project manager. And in most of the cases, there is no place for such people on site who are not treating women as they should be. And if they're treating the woman different, only because she's a woman. But it's like 1% of the situation, so don't worry about that. In most of the cases, it's really great. And I like to work with guys. And also what I like is that I think they are more straightforward. So if they like something, they tell you straight away. If they don't like, they tell you as well. And also, I think it's maybe less gossips than when you work with the ladies only.
Yeah. Great to hear that. Yeah, I think about the gossips, you would be probably surprised how men can gossip in between themselves. It might be crazy. But yeah, the good thing you mentioned actually that some people on site, and this, guys, everywhere I work myself on big projects, small projects, medium companies, big companies, there's always going to be someone who's actually not fit there. And if it's management, I think the some management staff, they under the stress and they might act in rude or arrogant way. That means they're not fit for purpose, really. They cannot cope with the stress. And if it's about workforce, like Eddie said, she had some 1% maybe of situation with the workforce. The people like this shouldn't be working there. They need to learn to work with people. So if it's my side, for instance, if you come to me, you're going to tell me the problem. I'm going to be getting rid of these people. So it's simple as, guys. It might be one chance given, but people like this have no place in construction, and people like me and other management staff, we making sure the atmosphere is better and better on construction site. And believe me, this is changing within time. It's changing on a daily basis. People are learning how to work with other people, and bad people are actually out. So yeah, I think people would like to hear what your main duties now as a project manager assistant, and what do you do on a daily basis, and what your work is all about.
So at the moment I have quite long list of my duties. So at first I am doing the induction and welcoming new people on site, making sure all of the documents, paperwork is on place. As you know, UK is now out of the EU, so we need to make sure visa and paperwork is on place so the people can be paid. And then we are coming to the payroll. I am controlling the hours, so also making sure everyone is paid correctly, how many hours they worked, overtimes, and always paid on times. And you might be surprised how big problem can be if you miss few hours by mistake. This kind of situation may even make people leaving the job. So you always need to make sure everyone is paid on time and the proper money. This is very, very important. The next things I was dealing with health and safety. So we had health and safety advisor on site, and she was a lady as well. I was in contact with her, making sure everything is correct on site, all of the documents, checklist, paperwork, and of course the site itself, everything is in a good condition and is safe for work. The next things I was doing, the small ordering small materials and small tools, maintenance, the big plants. This is something I was dealing with. So I was a contact between the site and the management, like the project manager and the buyers. The guys were coming, telling me what they need. I had to order that stuff and making sure we have that on time on site, because that's another problem. If something is missing, you are making a delay. So you need to always make sure everything is on site and on the time. I was also ordering the precast elements. This is something I was in contact with project manager. So he was telling me the dates based on the program, and my role was to order everything on time. And the basic documents controlling, so making sure everything is where it should be, and maintained all of the documents, paperwork, and trust me, it's like plenty of them, a lot of folders. So
yeah,
was something I was doing as well. And of course, assisting the project manager. So if he needs anything, then I was doing that.
Perfect. Thank you for this. Yeah, I think because of many people watching my channel, they actually aiming to be the project managers. So this is great to know what they're going to be dealing with. If they're going to go through the project manager assistant way, because you can always go by the engineering, senior engineer, then you can jump into project management as you're going to be working closely with the project manager. But the way Eddie is doing now, she actually paved her way towards the project management as well. And as you can see, she's doing like inductions, she's dealing with health and safety, she's doing the orders as well. She's like main link now between the site and the office and the ordering materials. So this is a stressful job as well, guys. Don't think it's easy. If you're gonna miss some order, if you want to make sure something gonna be on time, this causing the delays. And I think the delays are the biggest problems on site, and obviously health and safety have to be spot on, and as you heard, Eddie was dealing with it as well. So Eddie, one more question would be actually, what would you advise to all the women now who are thinking about starting construction, and actually to all people, the young students and everyone really who want to change maybe the industry and who want to start in construction, as I said?
So I would say, don't be afraid and try, make this first step. As you heard, I had no background, no experience, and I decided I want to change something in my life, and I am very happy I did what I did, and I'm also very happy that I was working on site directly. So if you have a chance, go to the site position first and then to the office-based position, because you can learn much more when you're working on site before you go into the office. And this kind of experience is great, because even for me, when I was doing different positions after, so I was a junior engineer and then I jumped to the document controller, PM assistant after, I could better understand what is going on, especially when I was ordering some materials. You might be surprised, but there is completely different language on site. They call the stuff completely different, and then you know what they're talking about. So if you can go on site, just do it, and don't be afraid. You can always go back to your previous job, but if you don't try, you never know if you like it. So make this first step, apply for a different position, different companies, and just do it.
Definitely. Yeah, thank you very much, Eddie. Thank you again for being here with us and for your great story. And guys, if you like it, please don't forget to leave the thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. Turn the bell on, as there's going to be more videos. There's going to be more great stories like this coming. And there are going to be people like Eddie who actually changed their career from completely different stuff into construction. She jumped into construction. And as you can see, she's working now as a project manager assistant, paving her way to PM role. And there will be people here who actually wanted to be in construction from the very beginning. Then they went to the civil engineering studies or some schools, colleges, and they were going step by step up the ladder to the project manager role, to the senior engineering positions. So guys, if you got any questions, Eddie promised me she's gonna be answering to them. If you wanna ask her something, she's gonna be still down there in the comments for you. And obviously you're gonna get some answers from me as well if you need anything. So thank you again and see you next time.